Today I'll talk about salvage at sea in the topic of maritime law for mariners. So this video has been made only for mariners who are intending to appear for examinations and they need some kind of material to answer questions in the written exam or oral exam. These are not for the maritime lawyers. These are only for mariners. So that's a quick disclaimer before I start with the video. So my first slide will define salvage and state the elements and the contributing parties to the salvage award. So salvage has been defined as the service which saves or helps to save a recognized object of salvage when in danger, provided that the service should be voluntary. It should not be part of any pre-existing legal or contractual obligation, and it should be rendered in the interest of self-preservation only. The service must be successful or partially successful, and the term salvage applies to the service performed by the salver or the reward paid to a salver in respect of successful services. Three elements must be fulfilled before the maritime property can give rise to a valid claim for a salvage award. Firstly, the service must be voluntary and not under any contractual official duty to render assistance. The property must be in danger and the danger must be real, and the service must be successful. Contribution towards the salvage awards shall be the owner of the salvage vessel, the charter of the salvage vessel, the owners of the cargo, owners of bunkers, the party to whom the freight is due, and salvage expenses shall be allowed as per York rules in general average if the act was so committed. So these are the parties who shall contribute towards the salvage awards. The criteria for fixing a salvage award are the following taken into account. First is the salvage value of the vessel, cargo and freight. Secondly, the skill and efforts of the salver in salving the property, that is cargo, the vessel and life. The measure of success obtained by the salver and the nature and degree of danger to which the salved property and the salver was exposed. The time utilized and the expenses and losses incurred by a salver shall also be taken into account. The risks run by the salver, the quantum of equipment that was used, promptness of service and response, and finally the skills and efforts of the salver in minimizing danger to the environment shall also be considered for fixing the award. What are the duties of the salver, owner and master during a salvage operation? Well, duties of a salver include to carry out salvage operation with due care. Secondly, to prevent or minimize damage to environment while carrying out salvage duties. Thirdly, when circumstances require, to seek assistance from other salvers. Fourthly, to accept intervention from other salvers when required by the owner or the master of the salvage vessel which is in danger. And fifth, to take the vessel safely to the destination nominated in the Lloyd's Open form. The duties of the owner and master include to cooperate fully with the salver throughout the salvage operation, to exercise due care to prevent or minimize damage to the environment, to make available all necessary vessel's equipment, to make available all relevant to performance of salvage, and when vessel has been brought to safe place, to accept the delivery and assistance bringing her in safety. What factors shall the master take into account before committing himself to a salvage operation? Well, the master should ask himself or herself whether the basic elements of salvage criteria have been satisfied. Does the charter party provide permission and have the owners and charters confirmed that permission? Has the possibility of delay to your own vessel been taken into account, bearing in mind the cargo, charter commitments, etc.? Does your vessel have skilled power or manpower, machinery, bringing in mind no cure, no pay? So you have to remember that if you do not sell, there might not be any award for you or no any compensation for you. Has the fruit of maximum salvage award been taken into account, that is value of the property and cargo freight that you may be able to salve? If it's not worth it, you have to think about whether it's going for the salvage is worth it or not. Can you cope with any oil pollution? Can you reach the port of destination, taking into account anticipated weather and stores on board? Have you mutually agreed upon the approximate salvage agreement to be used? So these are some of the factors that should be considered. Objective of salvage association and the role they play in protecting interest of owners and underwriters. Well, the Salvage Association is an association of shipping surveyors who act as a coordinating body on behalf of underwriters' interest and other concerned parties. They are a non-profit making body, and it will take steps to minimize the losses and assist in the recognition of repair yards and finalizing repairs from competent yards at competitive prices. Failure to inform underwriters result in deduction of reimbursement from the repairer bill under the tender clause. The Salvage Association is composed of professional surveyors and underwriters and can always be called whenever salvage is required or a casualty occurs or a major structural damage. They provide valuable guidance on economical efficient repairs, bearing in mind interest of all parties, and they are the link between repairers, underwriters and the ship owners. What is meant by no cure, no pay? Well, form of salvage agreement almost universally used in the Lloyd's standard form of salvage agreement has a number of advantages. However, all the usual conditions of salvage are implied in the salvage agreement, and further the agreement is based on no cure, no pay basis, which is also endorsed in the agreement. The owner of the property thus benefits from no cure, no pay basis. The term is defined in the salvage convention that as per the agreement, the service should be successful or partially successful in order to warrant payment. The clause was slightly modified over time to include payment for the protection of the environment. Finally, what are the advantages of the use of Lloyd's open form? Well, to the salver, the advantages include a ready agreement available, not likely to be contested by any parties. Though vessel shall be released, the salver still retains his right for lien. The remuneration is referable to arbitration and does not involve expensive, time-consuming court expenses. Finally, there is provision for special compensation even if salvage was unsuccessful, but salver prevented damage to the environment. To the owner, the Lloyd's Open Form has the following advantages. It has a readily available standard agreement. The principle of no cure, no pay is advantageous to owner, and the claim may be referred to arbitration instead of court. The property is not arrested for realizing claims, and in case of tankers, steps are taken by salver to limit the pollution. Experienced salvage operators are available for services to owners, thus ensuring care of the property.